Natty, it's been such a huge week. I mean, SummerSlam just wrapping up, but for you, it's been obviously a very emotional week with the passing of your father, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, and you were able to, at SummerSlam, walk down the ramp wearing your dad's jacket, be embraced by the WWE Universe. How did that feel, and kind of coming to the decision of being able to do that?
I wanted to honor my dad so much at SummerSlam, and it was a hard decision of even wanting to come because I wasn't sure if I was gonna be ready, because everything is so, you know, it was so fresh. It was literally 6 days after my dad had passed away, so I wasn't really sure whether I would even be like ready to come. I just felt like I needed to do as much as I could to honor my dad. I wanted to keep his memory alive. I knew that was a huge stage to do that on. I told my mom, I said, you know what, I think I'm gonna go to SummerSlam because daddy would want me to be happy. Yeah. And my dad would want me doing the things that I love. He wants me, WWE is my family.
Yeah.
I have the Hart family, but I also have the WWE Universe. I have all the talent backstage, all the superstars, all the women, the men that I share the ring with. Losing a parent, you know, it's just, it's tough. But for me, I also know that, like, you have to keep going. You have to, like, and I want to send that message to people, too, that are going through a hard time, that, like, bad things happen and sad things happen. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, we have to keep going. We have to dust ourselves off and we have to get up and we have to keep going. And there's gonna be times where I feel really sad and I'm gonna break down and cry. There's been a ton of those. I mean, I feel like I've cried so much that I can't even cry at all at this second.
Yeah.
But there's also gonna be times where I just wanna remember the happy times, because I'm not saying goodbye to my dad. Like, I've made my mind up that we're not saying goodbye to my dad, because I can talk to him at any time that I want. Mm-hmm. I can reach out to him, I can talk to him at any time I want. Now I just feel like I have an extra angel in heaven up there with my uncles Davey and Owen and my grandfather Stu Hart. So many people that have left us before, like, now they're gonna look after me. And my dad's gonna be having one hell of a party in heaven.
Well, I saw you do a post about that on social media, about what a party it was going to be up there, and you've been very vocal on social media. How's the reception been for you, from everybody being able to reach out and to be connected with people that are connected to you, but also have such a connection
to
your father?
Everybody has been so great, and people have been reaching out. The LA Times had done an article, and somebody posted it, and I'd never seen it before. It was so cool to see stuff I've never seen before of my dad, that everybody was pouring in, reaching out. And the article in the LA Times was just showing a picture of my dad when he was 18, that he was the second best shot putter in the world. My dad got a full scholarship to UCLA, and he was just this incredibly gifted athlete before he ever came to WWE, and all these great pictures and memories, and just people just sharing their thoughts. And I just feel very loved.
You're so brave and strong, and I've seen you go through so many different things, but to be able to see you step back in here after going through that and walking through the curtain wearing your dad's jacket, I think it's so cool for you to be able to do that and show people to be strong and keep, life keeps coming at you, so you keep kind of rolling with it. But how did you feel afterwards when you stepped backstage at the Barclays Center after being able to be in front of everybody in memory of your dad?
I felt great. I felt really, really great. This was not my moment at SummerSlam as much as it was Ronda's, because she was winning, it was her match.
Yeah.
And she let me share in that spotlight, which, you know, I'll be incredibly grateful forever for. But after all the smoke settled and the dust cleared with her celebrating her victory, I just remember Stephanie McMahon coming up to me and giving me this huge hug. And she just embraced me, like that motherly embrace that she has. She's really been wonderful, and everybody's just been so loving. And I just remember, like, I just had this release of tears. I hadn't cried all day yesterday at SummerSlam, and then I hugged her, and then I just, like, waterworks. And I was like, that's what you do with family. You can hug them, and like, just hugging her and just letting, and like, I just needed to let it out. Everybody's just been so wonderful, and I won't forget the love. I'll never, ever, ever, ever forget it. And I'm so grateful that I got to have a little bit more time to spotlight my dad.